I regret having my child. Warning, this content may be upsetting or disturbing to some audiences. Four disturbing stories of r/confessions, where people confess things they would not even share with their therapist. My obsession hurts others around me. It's also my fetish, but it goes far deeper than that. I'll try to explain the obsession the best I can, by explaining how it started. Basically, when I was young I caught pinworms. It was a strange feeling and the itch was painful. My parents took me to the doctor and I got medication to cure it. This event is what sparked my obsession. The thought that my body could be their whole world, their lifeline. Almost a planet of sorts. It was so interesting. After that I began researching pinworms and other parasites. And I found out the human body already hosts parasites, such as Demodex on their eyelashes, and I wanted to know how many a human body could endure without a chance of serious health issues. This curiosity has plagued my mind for years. I'm now 25, but I am very well versed in parasites as I have been studying them for over 10 years. I also purposely infect myself with non-lethal parasites because it's part of a fetish of mine. Some have worked better than others. Quite a few have given me serious diarrhea and fevers, while others have been much more bearable. I currently have pinworms and tapeworms, various non-pathogenic protozoa and pubic lice. I am incredibly masochistic, so although it's uncomfortable I do feel pleasure from it. All these parasites mean I need to eat a lot more than the average person and I still look thin, and to be quite honest it means I can enjoy so much more food than most people. I also keep multiple cultures of bed bugs and leeches in containers and allow them to feed on my blood sometimes, although those kinds are not really my passion as they do not live primarily on the human body, but I think they're interesting nonetheless, and I find them pretty cute. Now it's time for the confession. My obsession and fetish isn't just about infecting myself anymore. I also have the desire to infect others and I have acted on those desires. Sometimes my parasites just pioneer to new lands on their own. My family have caught pinworms multiple times without my intention, and other times I purposely spread them. I have infected strangers, friends and even my own family. I know it's bad but I just can't stop. I think I have parasites in my brain that makes me feel like I need to spread them. I know how crazy that sounds but if you knew the feeling you'd understand. Maybe it's just a mental illness, or maybe its origin is parasitic in nature, I really don't know. All I know is it feels good when I do these things. I feel an intense need to spread my children and when I do I feel pleasure. I must have spread thousands of my children over the years. I sometimes sprinkle tapeworm eggs into people's drinks when I'm out at clubs. I also caught pubic lice from sex with a random woman I met at the same club, and in return I'm pretty sure I gave her pinworms, so it was a trade. The woman wasn't even attractive, I just wanted to gift her some pinworms, and instead I basically won the jackpot by sleeping with her. I then spread my pubic lice to at least four other women. Sometimes I also sprinkle worm eggs onto food and buffets whenever I visit them. Yes, I understand you would think it's gross and messed up. I am basically betraying my species for my children. It's hard. I do enjoy people and I have wonderful friends and family, but I also love my parasites and my fetish is just too hard to control. I don't want to hurt anyone when I do these things but a force beyond my understanding is driving me to do it. I think I could possibly have a parasite in my brain that has not yet been discovered. I'm sorry to all the people I have caused discomfort to, but it's for a cause beyond human understanding. Although this all can be justifiable, I still feel guilt. I don't want to hurt anyone. I hope the people I spread my gifts to can find it in their hearts to be a little more open-minded, and not kill my children, but learn to live with them like I have instead. I'm aware how strange and disgusting others will find me if they knew. I'm aware of how immoral this seems to most people. I assume you may see me in a negative light after reading this, but remember I only want what's best for my children and if you were truly in my shoes I'm sure you would do the same. I'm putting my extremely profoundly disabled 7-year-old into a residential facility, so I can forget he exists. I'm not sorry. I can't tell anyone this, even my therapist. Lambaste me if you want and maybe I even deserve it. I only ask what you would do if you were in my situation. Not what you think people should do. What you would really do. I'm a single mom of two boys. 12 and 7. My husband passed away 3 years ago in a work accident. A very large portion of me believe it was a suicide. I can't see him ever making the mistake he made that caused his death, and he had taken an action just before that which ensured his co-workers weren't in the room. I fully believe he killed himself because of our younger son and no one will ever change my mind. We were told when I was pregnant that he would have Down syndrome. We could handle that. Even if it was severe. It turned out he has a chromosome deletion. His disorder is kind of rare, so I won't post which specific one, but suffice to say he'll never be anything more than he is now or has ever been. And what he is nothing. He doesn't appear to have any awareness and never has. His eyes are locked in one position, he doesn't respond to noise, touch, or pain. He is total care. He is capable of nothing. He is tube-fed and on oxygen. He is in diapers and will be forever. He makes no sounds, no attempts to communicate. He never even really cried as a baby. He has never made an attempt to interact with anyone or his environment. I'm not upset because I got a special needs and imperfect child. I feel the way I feel because this thing takes up 200% of my time and does nothing. I didn't get an imperfect child. I didn't get a child. I don't love him. He doesn't have any personality, there is nothing to love. And yet I'm responsible for him. In addition to his extreme delays, he's also medically fragile. Respiratory crises, fecal impactions, his autonomic nervous system doesn't function properly, issues with his G-tube, infections, pressure sores no matter what we put him on or how we position him. Our older son has suffered because his non-existent brother has colored everything in his life. His medical care gets delayed because there's only one of me and his brother is more critical. We do have a visiting home nurse but only 20 hours a week and we aren't eligible for more. I was starting law school, I gave up my dreams and my plan for my children for this potato. My older son can't do a lot of things he wants to do because of the younger's need for care and appointments. The final straw was I heard a sound. I went into younger son's room to check, thinking he had forgotten how to breathe again, and saw a older son hitting him and screaming, "You're why I don't have a mother. You're why I don't have a father. You're why I can't have friends over. You're why I can't be in sports. I didn't ask for you and I hope you die." Instead of being horrified, I watched. And younger son just did. Not react. No signs of pain or fear or upset. No reaction at all. He breathes but he is not alive. He doesn't know who I am. He doesn't know who older son is. He has no sense of self, life experience, or awareness of his surroundings. He doesn't need to be in my home. He doesn't know or care where he is. He is genetically my son but he is not family. My previously abused, brain-damaged cat who can't walk straight has more personality and is far more lovable than my child. In fact, I was looking forward to raising a Down's baby. Even one with severe impairments, for that reason. With disability can come gifts. This boy is not a gift. He is a genetic mistake I probably should have miscarried and would have definitely terminated if I'd known he would be like this. And the flip side is, if he has awareness, he's miserable. And there is nothing I can do. If he has likes and dislikes, no one knows what they are. If he is in pain, he can't tell anyone. If he wants anything, he can't communicate. He's had every imaginable therapy, nothing has made a difference. And so he's leaving our home on the 29th. I feel excited and relieved and then guilty because I know we'll be happier with him gone. He's already taken my husband and my son's father. He was working so much, to pay for the cucumber's care. For the experimental therapies insurance wouldn't cover. Because this one was going to be the breakthrough. He was tired and defeated and disappointed. He sought counseling as well but I don't think he could ever say the words "I don't want my son in my home either." He's ruined my older son. I was so wrapped up on the younger I never realized how ignored and damaged he was. He lost his father too. I didn't just lose my husband. He is my priority now and this malignant lump can be someone else's problem. At least they'll be paid a wage to care for him. At least they'll get a break from him when they punch out. I just want to never think of him again and I'm not sorry. And for that, I'm sorry. Thanks for listening. I accidentally killed my brother. Throw away because a lot of people know that this happened to me. I'm going to leave out a lot of details too just so it can't be easily traced back to me. I'm just living with so much guilt. I need to get this out because it's hard to talk about with people that I know. When I was 10, I had a little brother who was 2 and a half. We spent a lot of time with our neighbors because our moms were friends and they had 4 kids around the ages of my siblings. One day, we were exploring in the wooded area behind our houses and I found a huge rock. It looked like it had smaller shiny rocks in it, it wound up being a piece of cement with metal shards in it, and I thought it was pretty and wanted to take it home. Once we got back to our house though, our mom told us all to pack into the neighbor's car as we were going to Chuck E. Cheese. The rock was heavy so I brought it with us rather than lugging it home. My neighbors had one of those huge vans that sat like 15 people and had shelves above the seats so I put the rock in one of the shelves, and struggled to do so, as it was so heavy. Long story short, my baby brother sat below that shelf. At some point when the van stopped, the rock fell out of the shelf and crushed his little head. It wasn't super gory, but it was bad enough to have killed him right away. Right in front of my mom, me, my brother, sister, and our friends and their mom. At an intersection during a red light. I just remember my mom screaming, "Where did that come from?" and "Oh God, my baby," over and over again. It came out as a whisper at first, but eventually I was about to choke out an audible me, and I'll never forget the look on my mom's face. It was a mixture of pure grief, knowing my brother was dead. Anger, because I had done something so dumb that it resulted in the death of her youngest child. And compassion, because I know she wanted to hug me and tell me it wasn't my fault. But she couldn't at that time. She's regretted it for years and has apologized to me over and over, but all she said at that moment was, "You killed your brother." I'm 26 now, and it's been 16 years since my brother died, and I'm still in therapy. My family has assured me every day since that it wasn't my fault and nobody blames me, and that's a sweet sentiment, but it was still my fault. It was an accident, but I still directly caused it. That sweet little baby is dead because of me, and I can't escape it. Watching my parents grieve like that was unbearable, and they still feel so much pain. I just can't stand the pain anymore. My whole life has been a wreck since then, and I can't seem to get myself on track. I'm a high school dropout who has to leave work at least once a month because of my severe and constant panic attacks. I have full days where I'm paralyzed and can't get myself out of bed. I feel like I should be dead, and not my brother. If you read all of this, thank you. It was hard to write. I just need the universe to know that I haven't forgot what I've done, and I want everyone to know that I'm so sorry. I'll never forgive myself, and I'll never forget. I regret having my child. I was married for 15 years to my high school sweetheart. We had two beautiful kids, 13 and 9. For many reasons, we divorced. Skip to me starting to date again a year later. I meet an amazing woman almost right away, first month of dating again. We have a ton in common. We fall in love very quickly. She tells me early on that she wants kids. I had never wanted more kids. Two was more than enough for me. I had even made an appointment to get snipped later that year. But this woman is perfect for me, and having kids is a deal breaker for her. So I decide I could do this all again, for her, for us. I'm approaching 40 when we finally start trying. Due to some health complications, she's over 35, and has high blood pressure, we ended up having to do IVF. It worked, and we were pregnant soon afterwards. But our son was born prematurely. They warned us this was a possibility due to her age/health. He had to stay in the NICU for 3 months. My new wife developed postpartum due to the stress. We found out our son had cerebral palsy. A milder form, but he had it. Our world shifted from being a happy couple with a new baby to a depressed and stressed couple dealing with a child that has a lifelong disability. This is not how I perceived my second chance at happiness was going to be. I won't leave my wife. And I will love and take care of our son forever. But not a day goes by where I don't regret my decision to have more kids. I should have listened to my gut from the beginning and called off the relationship early on. She wanted kids, and I didn't. But I did this for her. Now I'm depressed, financially strained, and my future isn't the relaxing one I pictured. I can never tell my wife this, of course. And I feel bad even writing this to you all of you. But I just needed to get it out. Thanks for listening to this very disturbing episode of Radio TTS. The topics confessed in this video are things that people would not talk about, but they exist and are part of life. Hit the subscribe button and activate the bell for more videos like this.